Dave Morris in downtown Oklahoma City, right outside the Oklahoma City Museum of Art. Tonight is the screening of Creep, which stars Judd Nelson and Amar Nandal. We had a chance to catch up with the Hollywood star, Mr. Judd Nelson, who said that the Oklahomans that he has encountered so far in his first trip to the Sooner State have been quite friendly. So Judd, it's great to meet you.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here. This is my first time to Oklahoma City. I dig it.
What are your impressions so far?
Everyone's nice and polite, you know? No one's, like, angry. Doesn't feel like a, you know, urban, angry center, you know?
Well, hopefully that doesn't change throughout the weekend.
Yeah, hopefully not.
All right, so Creep, you're in the movie. Tell us, first of all, what should we expect from Creep? What should we know about it?
Got myself in a bit of a situation.
Well, I think it's a story about the things people do to overcome loss. You know, I guess that's the most general way to put it. It will be very beautiful to look at, and hopefully it will also be beautiful to experience.
Now, while chatting with Judd Nelson, I asked him, with all the Hollywood remakes, such as Baywatch of 80s and 90s movies and TVs, what about The Breakfast Club? And he said, no, not after the passing of John Hughes. He didn't think that would be appropriate. And here's his comments on that. Shows, has there been any talk of remake of Breakfast Club?
There's always been a little bit of talk of it, but I hope it's something that they don't do, because to do it without Hughes, you know, you really can't do it without him.
Any questions?
Yeah. Does Barry Manilow know that you raid his wardrobe?
A brain.
If he were around, sure, you know. But it would just be a bad imitation, I think, you know. And that's a fast horse, you know. You can't remake that. I think they... When they remade Psycho, it was rather odd, because they did that shot for shot. And you wonder, well, why? You know? But I think, it's great that people would consider it. It's really stood the test of time, and I'm very fortunate to have been a part of it.
Friendly. We also spoke with Amar Nandal. It's her first time producing. She stars in the movie in the title role of Creep. But she also talked about being behind the camera, producing, and some future productions. More productions from you in the future?
Oh, definitely. I want to... First, make sure that this is marketed well and people can see it, whether they like it or not, they go see it. And there's a few things that are out there, but I'm focused on this being sold and make money and then.
One of your co-stars is Judd Nelson. He spoke very highly of you. How was he to work with?
Oh my gosh, we were so lucky. When you work with a micro budget on 3 weeks of filming, it's just very difficult. And to have such a professional, passionate, committed person there, because he really worked hard to make sure the scenes were well made. Even in the short time we had to make him, he just went out there and helped us all, and we all fell in love with him. We all had a blast with him. We were all in the middle of nowhere in Dumas, Texas, and we all became friends, and I think friends for life.
And we had a chance to catch up with artistic director Lance McDaniel, who says the Dead Center Film Festival in its 17th incarnation is rolling along and has been particularly beneficial for those who are looking for film distribution. You mentioned something the other day about the business side of things, of getting filmmakers with distributors.
It's been fantastic for that. So we've had several high-end filmmakers that came here partially in distribution deals, and they got to meet with Warner Brothers while they were here. They got to meet with the film company, and so we, Shorts TV, Films That Matter, were the five different distributors we had. And what's great is last year the Shorts TV woman bought four or five films, and it's very hard to sell a short film because that's not really their intent, but she actually distributes all of the Oscar shorts, and so they've got a kind of a known audience that wants it, and their 230 million people have researched their stuff. So for short filmmakers, it's awesome. And there were two Oklahoma filmmakers that sold to Shorts TV last year, so they got a global distribution. So it's exciting. And then there are a lot of feature filmmakers here that got to meet with Warner Brothers, and some of them that feel like that's going to help them expand their distribution as well.
Has the online distribution changed that any?
1,000%. So what online distribution has done is it's allowed people like me, who makes shorts and small movies and big movies, to have a variety of ways to release. So even if you're not going into movie theaters, and I've done that with one movie, but sometimes if I'm making a much more lower budget movie, it's better for me to go directly to consumers through Amazon, through iTunes, through Hulu, through something like that, so that and Vimeo, so that I can get the money more directly. You know, so I believe that online distribution has been been a godsend for independent filmmakers and especially the kind of people that come to Dead Center. I think it's great.
17th annual Dead Center Film Festival continues through Sunday, various screenings in five locations around downtown Oklahoma City, some educational seminars, including the future, some tech 3D virtual reality on Sunday, and more screenings of the Harkins Bricktown Cinemas as well. More Dead Center information can be found at deadcenterfilm.org.